Hi. Yeah, today we're just going to do a short one, I think, on Ephemeris III. I've collected, last night I collected about a half hour, three half hour plus minute of generated music from this pure data thing that I've been working on. One of the three tracks I intend to reverse. These are performances that I did yesterday and captured them using OBS because I can't figure out any easier way to do it. The other one has a little problem at the end that I have to edit, so that's the second thing I should do. And then I need to lay in the bass track that I also recorded yesterday. And then basically just kind of clean it up. And this could potentially take a while. If it gets too boring, then I'll just quit. And anyway, we'll see how it goes. So the first thing is just the first track that I'm going to reverse. They sound pretty good so far. So that's the track that will be reversed. I want to listen to the track that won't be reversed just to see what that's. Pretty much the same. It's not the same content, but it's pretty much the same. Just want to leave one going forward and the other one going backward. So we'll have that kind of reverse reverb thing. So one advantage of that is that if I'm doing reverse, then some of these attacks are and you can't hear me, can you? Sorry about that. I don't know how much of that I got on mic. So the advantage to reversing it, some of these have hard attacks and some of them have slow attacks, like kind of reverse triangular attacks. I'll show you what I mean. Those attacks are kind of rounded. There's a slow attack and a slow decay, relatively. So they kind of go voom, 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 voom. Now, that's a symmetrical envelope, you can reverse it and it'll sound pretty much the same. The only thing that will change significantly is where the reverb is. Is it before the note happens or is it after the note happens? And then later, it changes. Okay, here the attack is getting a little harder. I know I changed it a lot. Right, so these sound more like bells, a little closer, like soft bells. Okay, still pretty soft. Yeah. Those sound pretty cool. Right, so this will sound pretty good reversed. I'm just going to go ahead and reverse it. Okay, done. Let's have a listen. Sounds almost the same, doesn't it? Oh, I had the wrong. It sounds the same because it is the same. Here's the reverse one. That's awesome. I may reverb that too. Let's see what that sounds like. That's pretty cool. You get those kind of pre-echoes, kind of ghostly, reminiscent sounds. It's pretty cool. Ooh, I like. All right, let's put them together, see what it sounds like. Okay, so far I like it. It's what I kind of hoped for. But I know in this track there's some shenanigans near the end. I think that's it right there. Let's have a listen. Yeah, that was it. I need to get rid of that. The trick is just to make it as subtle as possible, but I think that's the only bit, if I recall. I recall doing this last night and making that mistake. I was trying to slowly change levels, and I ended up doing it quickly, and it created a crackle that I didn't want. So there it is right there. It's very subtle, but I'm going to get rid of it anyway. Nice. Now I'm just trying to figure out what the best ending and beginning can be, and just kind of leave the rest to fate. Yeah, that might be all right. Let's save it, see how it's at the beginning. Let's drag it over a little. Just deciding on an ending.
Thank you.
Okay, this all sounds pretty good. This all sounds pretty good. I think I'm going to mix it down and have a listen to it later. But wrap it up. It's a quick one. I love using MixBus as a mixing mastering station. Not so much for working on stuff as much, but for this kind of thing. Moving tracks into it and then mixing it here is really good. I like it. So I'll fade out on this and say goodbye for today. So, ciao.